YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. This is a donut, or more precisely, a most delicious torus. Any torus, delicious or not, has two radii, a major radius and a minor radius. There are many different types of tori, ring tori, horn tori, and spindle tori. In theory, the laws of physics do not forbid the existence of torus-shaped planets. In practice, however, it's extremely unlikely that they could form naturally and remain stable over geological timescales. But let's speculate a little. Let's say a toroidal world did exist. What would a donut Earth look like? For starters, donut planets would probably look like ring tori, with their major radius being no greater than 3 times their minor radius. This is important. If the ratio of the radii exceeded 3, the planet would become unstable and break up into smaller, co-orbiting blobs. In short, tin hula hoop planets are way less stable than chunky, donut-like planets. Stability would always be a concern for donut worlds. They would naturally want to degenerate into a sphere. Why? Because gravity. So to counteract the force due to gravity, a torus world would need to spin fast. See, gravity causes matter to collapse inwards, while centrifugal forces would pull matter outwards. So if a donut world had a very high rotation rate, the centrifugal forces generated would balance out the force of gravity. This would ensure that the planet would remain stable and retain its toroidal shape, i.e. it won't collapse into a sphere. Now, the faster the rotation, the shorter the days. Days on a torus world would be no longer than a few short hours. Additionally, the rotation would deform the tube of the planet. The cross-section would not be circular, but rather oval or egg-shaped, with sharper curvature on the inside than on the outside. As such, surface gravity on a toroidal world would not be uniform. It would be at its weakest along the interior and exterior equators, and, rather interestingly, strongest just hubward of the poles. It's hard to give exact figures here. For spherical planets, we use this equation to calculate the surface gravity. For donut worlds, things get messy. We'll need something more like this. Luckily, computer simulations come to the rescue. One such simulation shows a toroidal world with an equatorial surface gravity of 0.3 g, and a polar surface gravity of 0.65 g. That's a 216% difference. Pretty cool, eh? The tidal forces felt by any planet in the habitable zone of a main sequence star are given by 1 over the mass of the star to the 5th power. So given that torus worlds are prone to being torn apart by tidal forces, placing such planets in orbit around stars more massive than our sun would be very prudent. Right, let's imagine a donut planet that meets all the above criteria and has an axial tilt similar to Earth's. What would the seasons be like on such a planet? Well, the Rimbert tropics would have a fairly constant inflow of solar energy throughout the year, and the day-night cycle would be fairly Earth-like, albeit the days would be extremely short due to the planet's rapid rotation. At the poles, there would be sun for half a year, followed by polar night for the other half. Close to the hubward equator inside the hole, things would be a bit more temperate. Day and night would return with greater regularity, plus there would be a significant amount of refracted light. To explain, imagine standing inside the hole and looking up. You would see the other side of the planet arc across the sky. This band could be something like 20 to 30 degrees in the sky perhaps. For context, our sun is 5 degrees in the sky. Now, light hitting this huge and awe-inspiring arc would be refracted back to the night side of the hole and would help illuminate it. In extreme cases, nighttime inside the hole could, due to this refraction, be as bright as an overcast day on Earth. Because of the high rotation rate, the atmosphere would act more like Jupiter's than Earth's. Expect banded zonal climates and intense winds. Heat transfer would be much less effective, so the difference between hot and cold regions would be much greater than that on Earth. Hurricanes on a torus planet would be spun up by intense Coriolis forces into tightly wound systems, many times smaller than their counterparts on Earth. Continental drift would be affected by the different inner and outer radii. Plates would have to shrink in size as they travel towards the inside of the hole. As a result, plates moving hubwards would experience folding, and plates moving rimwards would experience rifting. So expect rugged mountainous terrain inside the hole, and if the surface gravity is very low, expect those mountains to be many times higher than the likes of Everest. Interestingly, simulations modeling the internal heat distribution of donut worlds show that the thermal gradient would be higher at the poles than at the equator. What this means is that the polar crust would be very thin, so volcanism and geothermal activity would be more prevalent at the poles. Where Earth has its Pacific Ring of Fire, a donut world may have polar rings of fire. Okay, let's talk moons. There is a Lagrange point in the center of the hole. Unfortunately, it's unstable. Place a moon there and the slightest gravitational tug would send it flying off into space. Or crashing into the surface of the planet. Not great, eh? Now, in theory, a moon could bob up and down through the center of the hole. Or orbit in a rectangular region over a particular longitude. Or even precess along the hole, filling in a vase-shaped orbit. A figure 8-shaped orbit through the hole is also theoretically viable. Such an orbit would likely precess, tracing out the shape of a larger torus encasing the donut world. Realistically, these orbits would quickly decay due to the destabilizing nature of the tidal forces at play between the donut and its moon. However, artificial satellites capable of orbital correction may be placed in these exotic orbits. Sadly, for natural satellites, the most plausible orbit is a far-out circular orbit, lying exactly in the elliptical plane. On a final note, the four-color theorem tells us that no more than four colors are required to color a map, so that no two adjacent regions have the same color. Due to its morphology, cartographers living on a torus-shaped world would need at least seven colors to achieve the same goal. So, weird, temperamental, and deliciously colorful, donut planets are a delicious treat of hypothetical exo-confectionery. This video is based upon the blog post Torus Earth by Anders Sandberg. Many thanks go out to Anders for allowing me to use his work to help make this video possible. Links to Torus Earth in the doobly-doo. Now consider this the briefest of introductions to the weird world of Torus planets. Such a complex and highly speculative subject cannot be fully covered in one short video. As such, I've left a ton of links in the doobly-doo concerning tori in general and Torus planets in particular. There's some really great stuff in there, I'd recommend checking it out. As always, click the links on screen for more Artifexian content, videos, podcasts, etc. Like and subscribe, and thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.